war itself had become more perilous. The weapons had evolved. But our orders remained the same. Hunt them down and kill them off, one by one.
They are the immortal damned. One family lusting for power and wealth.
The chain has never been broken, not in 14 centuries.
Another driven by revenge.
Soon we'll defeat the vampires on their own ground.
This human. He's attractive. I can't be positive, but I'm beginning to think the Lycans are following him.
I don't like him.
Why are they after you?
Who are you people?
You're in the middle of a war that's been raging for the better part of 1,000 years. A blood feud between vampires and Lycans. Werewolves.
Decision must be made.
Why did you bring him here? You saved my life.
Between an oath sworn centuries ago.
A human. He's not a human at all. He's a Lycan.
And the power.
There can be no such union.
Greater than vengeance.
You'll be lucky if I can convince the council to spare your life.
Absolution will be yours the moment you kill Michael.
Underworld is an action fantasy thriller movie that was released on September 19th, 2003. This is the movie that started the whole Underworld franchise. It stars Kate Beckinsale and is directed by Len Wiseman. But I will ask the same old question, is it good? Well, let's find out, as always, by starting with the story. Okay, the story follows a war going on between vampires and werewolves. A vampire warrior named Selene takes interest in a human doctor named Michael Corvin. However, Michael is pursued by werewolves for unknown reasons. Selene tries to figure it all out. Let's start with the positives. I fucking love the world that this movie creates. It is mixed with imagination and the macabre. And it is fascinating to see it come to life. It really helps me get invested in the story. And I'm a bit of a sucker for 2000s era action fantasy movies like this. I also think that Selene is a fucking great character. She's written as a character before her gender. It really fucking helps you root for her and even relate to her. She is the embodiment of how you write a strong female character. I also really like the romantic subplot with Michael. I think it really adds to the conflict of this movie and is one of the things that got me excited for this movie before I saw it. But despite what I said, I felt it was not as focused on as I hoped it would be. I mean, it is believable that Selene is falling for Michael. But as the movie goes on, that story seemed to take a back seat, and it does not have that much emotion incorporated. Which leads us to the negatives. When the movie begins, it is all cleverly set up, and I really was on board with the movie. However, after the chase scene that includes Selene and Michael, the movie becomes pretty fucking boring. It is slower paced and not much actually happens. The writing also becomes weaker. I don't think there are any fucking standout quotes in this portion of the movie. To be quite honest, it almost put me to sleep. Almost. I think one of the reasons that it was like this is because the movie is 2 hours long, and I would argue that it really didn't need to be that long. It feels like the filmmakers were just filling up the time with a bunch of goddamn shit that was not as interesting as they... that was not as interesting as they thought. The action scenes are also not that great. The first scene was okay, but the rest of the action is very goddamn underwhelming. You get a few gunshots, but they either are too short or not that... You get a few gunplay scenes, but they're either way too short or not edited very well. What I said goes double for the final action scene. It seems like it was rushed to complete. That is a big fucking problem in an action movie, because the climax ideally should be where the movie is at its A game. But it was pretty disappointing. Now let's move on to the production values. The cinematography is really fucking good. It is really dark and manages to have everything visible. It also perfectly matches the tone of that the movie's world is going for. It's the farthest thing from Shining Time from Thomas and the Magic Railroad. But finally, it makes it an excellent movie to watch at night or on a rainy day. The editing is good, at least not during the action scenes. The sound is up to the standards of movies made around that time. The music is pretty forgettable, though. Overall, Underworld is a pretty good introduction to the Underworld franchise. The characters and setting, and definitely the cinematography alone, make this movie worth seeing at least once. However, I felt there were some areas that this movie really fucked up in. Not enough to piss me off, but still. The middle and the end part of the end of the movie were pretty boring, and the action scenes were subpar. But what I'm saying about this movie sounds a lot worse than the way I really mean it. I'm really glad I did see it for the elements that I did like, and can see why it was critically acclaimed and became a blockbuster franchise. Therefore, I give Underworld 3 out of 5 stars with the title of Earth Watching. Anyway, I'm Spike Robot. If you like this video, you can subscribe to my channel, and see you next time. Support our troops.
Farming once, but not again.